Hello and welcome to another tutorial brought to you by Dome 3D. My name is Matt Mascheri and we're going to be reviewing the new Vray Dome camera and comparing it to the Mental Ray Dome AFL shader camera. Now for the longest time we've had issues with the Vray fisheye render not lining up exactly with the Mental Ray camera. And in some instances we might want to be using Mental Ray because there are some nice shaders, or we can more effectively create something using the Mental Ray renderer versus Vray. So after bugging Vlado, one of the main guys over at Chaos Group, for a very long time, he was able to come up with a nice little nifty tool called the Vray Dome camera, which can be found under your cameras in the drop down here, Vray Dome camera. And the real cool thing about this is that not only does it not require you having to go and set up all of those fisheye parameters within the renderer anymore, but I've got mine set to a field of view of 180 degrees, but if you watch this area right now and I bring it down to, you know, 160 or so, it actually gives you pretty much a full dome preview right within 3D Studio Max. So you can really get a good idea of what's dome center, dome left, dome right, dome back. Okay, so for my sample scene here, what I wanted to do, or what I have done, is actually created just a simple scene, plain, bunch of T-bots, and then a single light. Right now I've got a set as a V-Ray Omni light with shadows all set up. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and set up V-Ray to render out through the V-Ray Dome camera, and then set up Mental Ray to render out using the Dome AFL shader. So let's go ahead and get Vray all set up. Just for the heck of it, I want to enable GI, so you can turn on GI here. And for my GI engines, I'm using Radiance Map and the Light Cache. I'm setting my current preset down to medium animation just to add some speed, get it done a little bit quicker. Show the calc phase. I like to see what's kind of going on. You can scroll on down and under Light Cache, go ahead and show calc phase again. So when I go ahead to render, I'm going to go ahead and build a light cache, and we'll be back in a second. Okay, so our render is all done. It only took about 24 seconds, but didn't want to make it feel like you should be waiting while that was rendering out. So we've got our Vray camera set, so I'm just going to go ahead and save that out to the desktop. Vray PNG, and okay. Alright, so now what we can go ahead and do is make our switch over to Mental Ray. So I'm going to first, since we're on the light over here, I'm going to switch that over to cool Mental Ray, and then over in the renderer, switch that over to Mental Ray, go over to the renderer, Lens, Dome AFL, open up Material Editor, drag that over, Field of View 180. We want to make sure, of course, that that matches up with the Vray, which was also 180. Of course, Flip Y, that's the setting that we're using for this Dome AFL shader. Drag that back, it's all instanced. And what we can do is then select down here the Mental Ray camera and let it rip. Okay, now as you notice, the Mental Ray camera does clip at that spring line where the Vray actually renders all the way out. So the Mental Ray here is a little bit more efficient, but at the same time I didn't turn on any GI or Final Gather or anything like that. So let me go ahead and save out mr.png. All set. Okay, now we're going to bring this into Photoshop and take a look at the two. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop CS2, and we've got the Vray and Mental Ray PNGs all set and ready to go. So I'm just going to go ahead and select all on the Mental Ray, copy it over, and just paste it right over our Vray. Now again, you can kind of see that the Mental Ray does clip right here at the spring line while the Vray does continue to over-render But as you can see, they line up with exact precision. So for all you full domers out there, we now have the ability to render within Mental Ray using that Dome AFL shader, whether it's in Maya or Max, and having it line up exactly with the new Vray Dome camera. So if you got any questions, shoot me an email, matt@dome3d.com, and visit our web boards at dome3d.com/phpbb. Later.